is so excited to be here. And David is one of the most important parts of our tour, because without him, we'd be walking. And it's so cold, and it's so long. It's an hour-long tour, everybody. Can you imagine walking it? I couldn't. So we have David here to save the day as we leave the theme park and head to the world's largest and busiest production studio, Universal Studios. Again, I'm Katie. Your driver is David, and we have another person to introduce you guys, Mr. Jimmy Fallon.
Oh, hey there. You made it. Welcome to the Universal Studio Tour. I'm Jimmy Fallon. I'll be making sure that you get through this experience in one piece. You've got the very best guide.
Her name is Katie.
And the greatest driver.
His name is David.
They're the best. I love them. Even though
Katie
owes me $5.
Jimmy, please.
I know you guys are excited to get on the tour, but first, a few safety rules.
You know what, Jimmy? You're right. We do have a few safety rules to go over. If you need guest assistance or have a medical emergency, or if you drop something of value off the side of the tram or have any sound or video issues, reach up and grab the red e-cord that runs along the center of the ceiling of the tram, and I'll be back to assist you as soon as it's safe to do so. Otherwise, during the entire tour, please stay seated, keep your arms and legs inside the vehicle at all times, and remember to use the red cord above your head if you need any assistance. The studio is private property, and if at any time during the tour you drop your phone or just can't wait to use the restroom, hold the cord and remain seated. Please no smoking or vaping of any kind during the tour. And be prepared. Our tour today features loud noises, sudden tram movements, fire effects, and many water effects. You want to have your cameras out for great photo opportunities, but keep an eye on them so they don't get wet. And finally, for your safety and those around you, please do not use selfies while you're on board, and keep your facial coverings above your nose and under your chin for the duration of the tour, unless you are actively eating or drinking. All right, you guys, we are now heading down the Universal Studios movie timeline, and you're going to get a last glimpse of that lower lot. You can see that the Nintendo World is in construction. That big black pit over there. I'm so excited not to come to our theme park. But we are heading down the movie timeline. It depicts just a few of the movies that Universal has made over the past 100 years. Carl Lumley opened its West Coast doors on March 15, 1915. His dream was to create a self-sufficient, working movie studio. He wanted to create the strangest city in the world, because of course, what else could you create that would make movies? And for that to happen, you need a fire station. That was everyone's first guess, right? To the right, you're going to see Fire Station 51. We also have medical offices, a police department, and our own zip code.
Got it.
Yes, we are Universal City 91608. If someone wants to send me a postcard, send it to Katie. But one of the most integral parts to making movies is, I know everybody's thinking it, and I'm just gonna say it, a soundstage, right? We're all on the same page there? Perfect. I see you. I know you get it. Soundstages are the perfect place to make movies because they are a perfectly controlled environment. Soundstage 12 to your left, most recently home to The Voice, is our oldest and our largest soundstage. It is 30,000 square feet and it was built in 1928. The first film to come out of there was a musical called Broadway in 1929, but there have been so many since then. All right, you guys, staple that sentence into your hearts. A soundstage is a perfectly controlled environment. And we film Superstore here on our lot. We replicated a Superstore in one of our soundstages. It was one of the coolest sets ever, even though I had been to a real store. We are passing by Soundstage 44, where Mr. Mayor is currently filming. That's starring Ted Danson. But if you look to your left, at that Ted there, very cuddly, he's holding a martini right there. He's actually getting his own show soon. Very exciting for him. But he is welcoming us to our production bungalows. Now you might be, again, wondering, what is a production bungalow? And to that I say, it is every pre-production process that needs to begin before you can film in a soundstage where they perfectly control the environment for filming. That's right, all of our pre-production processes happen in these bungalows. Script writing, editing, casting, you know, production design, all of it happens in our bungalows. Currently housed here is Bramstone Street Productions, that's Elizabeth Banks Production Studio. In bungalow 5195, coming up on your left, that was Alfred Hitchcock's bungalow, but currently home there is our De Laurentiis company. They are your source for all Hannibal Lecter media that you see today. We also have 7 Bus Productions. That's Dwayne The Rock Johnson's production company, and he's currently working on Young Rock, a TV show about his life when he was younger. And to your left, you're going to see sound stages 22 and 23. They look a little bit different than normal sound stages, and that's because their production offices are in the front of the buildings. We filmed Hairspray Live in 2016 there. We also use those sound stages for Will and Grace, the revival series. And currently there is Keenan, starring Keenan Thompson, Chris Benn, and Don Johnson. And if you look to your right, we are now heading into our back lot. That's right, we've left the front lot and are now in the back lot, where we shoot exterior scenes on a grand scale. Exterior scenes are all the shots that are shot outside. If you look to your right, you're going to get a great view of our New York street. It's lit in blue. This is our metropolitan sets, or we call them the metro sets. This is where we can film any major city in the world, right here on our Universal Studios lot. We are currently passing by Central Park, and it's a little bit smaller than the actual one, but whatever. And our Brownstone Street.
Brace the dog!
I'm in the shower!
Inside bad, outside good.
And this is how we use the Brownstone Streets when we are actually filming out here. We dress up the street with some cars, some extras, and it looks like people really live there. But now, we are heading to our courthouse square, going 88 miles per hour, and we're heading to Hill Valley. That's right, that is our courthouse square. Currently they are using it for Rutherford Falls on our Peacock streaming service.
Nice place, sir.
Our New York street sets have also been used for American Ninja Warrior. They come in, they set up obstacle course, they film the semifinals and the finals in the same day. I bet you guys didn't know that. They break down the set and then they head home. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. But you know, there's somebody who knows New York Street a little bit better than I do. You guys met him a little bit earlier.
Hey everyone, welcome to New York! I got my start right here in New York on Saturday Night Live. This is actually my old neighborhood. What's got mugged over there? That old woman.
And that's him to talk to us about him.
You see, original King Kong, that made me I saw that movie on TV when I was about 8 or 9 years old, and I wanted to become a filmmaker. I like films that just take you away from your real life and sweep you up an adventure. Kong literally does that. I mean, you're on board the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Skull Island, and it's great to have you along for the ride. Now, we have created this 3D immersive experience, so you're going to have your glasses ready. Don't put them on yet, but just have them in your hand, because we're about to return to Skull Island.
That's right, and as we are returning to Skull Island, I want to remind everybody to remain seated, keep your hands and feet inside the tram, hold on to your belongings. things and hold on to your loved ones. It's going to be a bumpy ride. Picture car, and we have some pretty cool ones to show you guys up ahead. First in the cars is Kit from the 2008 Knight Rider Revival Series. also have some Back to the Future films. This car sans the manure. We also have some of my favorite, the Flintstones cars. You know, you guys wouldn't believe this, but they're not made of real wood. They are made of foam rubber and fiberglass. That's kind of crazy. The reason that they built those cars like that is because during filming, they actually filmed them on the back of flatbed trucks when the actors were looking like they were driving. Another car that is not as it seems is this Bradley fighting vehicle right here, the tank. It is made of pressed plywood and PVC piping, making it, again, a very lightweight vehicle. I would not recommend taking that one into battle. You might lose. But we are now heading off to an island off the coast of Costa Rica. I'm sure you guys know where we're going. That's right. We are going to see some of the set pieces that were used in the original franchise of Jurassic Park. We have the boat from Jurassic Park 3 and the mobile lab from Jurassic Park, The Lost World. We also have some dinosaur cages that, surprise, surprise, are made of lightweight materials. But they seem to be empty, and I think those dinosaurs are inside the mobile lab. Oh, that poor scientist. Don't worry, guys. We have to say hello just for you. And if anybody wants to take a picture with a Spinosaurus, she is popping her head out to say hello. Guys, she just ate. You can see her dinner right there. You want to know what else is fake here? The trees. Yes, even those trees are fake. Because filmmakers realized that actors didn't like it when real trees fell on them. Surprise, surprise. A lot of that stuff is made from different materials, you know. We like to simulate the real thing. So we want to give you a demonstration of a simulated rainstorm. We are going to show you a real thunderstorm and how we create it here on our Universal lot in Old Mexico, which you may have seen in Nacho Libre, The Three Amigos, Star Trek Picard, and HBO's Westworld. That thunder is made using Foley equipment, and the strobe lights actually create that lightning effect. And we use a very advanced technological system called sprinklers to create that rain. And those strobe lights have a double effect as well. They also light the rain so that it can be captured on camera. And that rain drops are a little bit larger than normal size for the same purpose. But you know what? We shouldn't keep this rain going on for too long, because something bad might happen, you know? You guys know what they are. Like a flash flood or something. Oh no, we kept the rain out for too long. Alright, you guys. That rain was huge. We're going to say adios, Old Mexico, and howdy to Six Points, Texas, where some of the largest stars in Hollywood got their names. This is the oldest lot on the Universal set. This was used when Silent Film era was still reigning supreme, and the westerns were being made by nobody's business. played over 200 westerns on these sets. And you know what? It looks like there's a few cowboys still here causing trouble. I guess I gotta say it. Please remain seated, keep your arms and legs inside the tram, and pull that right cord if you have an emergency, and I'll be back to assist you. Otherwise, sit back and relax. We are now passing by Park Lake. Park Lake was used for the musical Showboat and also Creature from the Black Lagoon. Park Lake is a man-made lake, but luckily it was created because we didn't have to go find an Amazonian rainforest to film our classic monster movie Creature from the Black Lagoon. In fact, in the 1930s, Tram had the idea that Universal needed to find its new niche. So he studied Gothic trends happening in Germany, and he brought the Universal movie monsters to our studios. In the birthplace of the movie monsters is where we're headed right now, Little Europe. That's right. This was Germany for Frankenstein, Transylvania for Dracula, but for Eleanor Shellstrop, it was afterlife.
You, Eleanor Shellstrop, are dead.
Cool. We're currently passing by all chocolate everything to your left.
Yes, you're in the good.
You're also going to notice a view of the yogurt shop corner. And to your right is everything fit.
Maybe it's not all my bad.
Come here. I'm
going to
help you.
What is the bad place?
Well, it doesn't sound awesome.
And we are turning into the Court of Miracles. The Court of Miracles is where we filmed the Cinderella, starring Whitney Houston, and Whoopi. We've also used these streets for Genovia, for Princess Diaries 2, A Royal Engagement. And you're going to see Railway 12358W from The Good Place. The Court of Miracles to your right was originally built in the 1930s for our Academy Award-winning film, All Quiet on the Western Front. It was Germany. But it was given its name from the Hunchback of Notre Dame in Paris. And Dracula, one of our famous movie monsters, was also shot here.
I am Dracula. Oi, Dracula.
You know what, you guys? I think that the sound sink just opened up and we can actually go look inside of it. I know we passed by those a while ago, but I think it's a great chance for you guys to view what actually happened inside of a sound stage. Now, it is a hot set, meaning we can't go onto the set because they are ready to film at any moment with the way they left it set up. So please remain seated, keep your arms and feet inside the tram, and hold on to your belongings. We don't want to mess up anything in here. This is a super cool opportunity, and it looks like they've dressed the set as a San Francisco metro station. So you can see they even have some product placement up. They have a craft and services table. They've got the sign. As I was saying, they've got...
Thank you.
nothing else could possibly go wrong in the city. Oh no. I think we all deserve a break. Who's up for a midnight dip at Amity Island? I heard that recently they caught a man-eating shark. Don't worry, we have some police scuba divers out there making sure that the water is just safe. You guys hear that super ominous music? And see that shark fin? Oh no, Officer George, get out of the water! Alright, everybody yell, get out on the count of three. One, two, three! Yeah! Officer George, don't fight the shark! Oh, he has a lot of guts to be doing that. Let's hide behind these cans of flammable gasoline and maybe we'll be safe. Okay, so it looks like the shark is taking the bait, but he's also taking the gear with him. That one's just a really bad fire. Shark attack! Oh, no. Did everybody survive? Alright, we got a really great close-up look, so I'm gonna ask, does anybody know what kind of shark that is?
Great white!
I'm hearing some awesome answers, and it's a plastic shark. And if you look back, I don't know if you can see very well, but it's the only shark in the world that can do the backstroke. You can look at him as he's going back. But that is not the same shark as the one on the set of Jaws. That one was much worse.
That's a much more
shark. The shark is much better.
That is Steven Spielberg posing with Bruce the Shark, named after his lawyer. And as we pass through Amity, we're heading into our residential set, but you might recognize this area also from Cabot Cove. From Murder, She Wrote. You know, it's crazy how many murders can happen in a small town. Angela Lansbury, what is your secret? We are also passing by our Elm Street to your left, and we are turning into our Chicken Ranch, which was used in the Bessel Whorehouse in Texas, but also used as the house in House of a Thousand Corpses. In fact, does anybody know the monsters? Yeah. Michelle, the monsters? Rob Zombie is actually going to be directing a new revival series of the monsters that is in the works. That house actually lives on our Colonial Street, which we are passing by right now. Colonial Train is also being used for Never Have I Ever, if we have any fans of that Netflix series. Colonial Street is also better known as Wisteria Lane. For any fans of Desperate Housewives, that's where they shot 8 seasons there. Now we are heading into our Wilderness Road. We are one of the only lots in the world to still have a Wilderness Road. And you know what? That's because we want to be able to control the environment that we film on. A horror movie, this is the perfect place to get lost in the woods. In fact, in Bird Box, this was where Sandra Bullock's campsite was. And we also film other disasters on this plot of land. We filmed a limousine crash from 911, where a limousine turned over. And you know what else you need when you film a car crash scene? I know we're all thinking it. Picture cars! And we have some more to show you guys. We have some cars from the Fast and Furious series, including Dom's black Charger. We also have Mr. Bean's little lime green car from Mr. Bean's Holiday. And we have Bumblebee from Bumblebee and a Decepticon police car. Now, if anybody noticed, we're on Janet Leigh Drive. Janet Leigh starred as Marion Crane when she drove to the Bates Motel in Psycho, which is where we are heading right now. We are heading to a hotel with 12 rooms and 12 vacancies. You know, this motel is run by Norman Bates. A lot of people say that he's pretty different, but honestly, I'd say that he's downright psycho. You might be able to see Mother in her rocking chair in that top window. And this was the set of Bates Motel for Psycho 2 and this original Psycho remake. This is the Psycho house where Norman and his mother live. This house was actually originally a facade. It only had two sides of the house. But just for us here at Universal, they built the other sides. And it looks like a completely nice house. Except where there might be somebody inside. To the next. Welcome to the crash site set of War of the Worlds. War of the Worlds was directed by Steven Spielberg and production designed by Vic Carter.
Because it's just something you don't see.
You're doing good. Listen, you close your eyes, okay? Stay closed.
Bobby, get in. Get in.
So that's what the crash site set looked like on the set of War of the Worlds. Steven Spielberg wanted a practical set, meaning that none of it was done using CGI. That was a real 747 airplane that they got from a plane graveyard in the Mojave Desert. Now we are about 10 minutes away from the end of our tour, but we are returning to the theme park shortly. So just sit back, relax, and pull that red cord if you need any assistance.
FBI, don't move. Damn, that's right, party's over.
You know how long I took to iron this shirt, man? I'm not...
You're under arrest right now.
Ladies, just back up a little bit. I got it. It's lightweight. First of all, I don't work for you.
Oh, really? Well, tell me, Roman, who do you work for?
We don't work for nobody. Not like we just clear out of here, otherwise we can't guarantee your safety.
Guarantee my safety? I'm the one holding the gun.
Yeah, but mine's a whole lot bigger than yours. Ops, escort this novice out.
Let's go, Cookie Puss.
You got an ugly suit on, man. It's cheap.
Somebody out there.
Dude, our whole family will protect you.
Are you kidding me, Roman? You didn't shut off your phone, bro?
I gotta call you back. I'm in another zone. Ops can't hold it forever. Buddy, Roman, we're up. Driver, move that vehicle. It's about to get real interesting. My Mona Lisa's all warmed up right next door.
Roman, grab your truck. I need you and Lenny ready to roll.
And there is nothing to worry about. David is behind the wheel.
Which one of you is the witness? Speak now or you all get fried!
This is our turn.
Of the Tram. Again, my name is Katie. I'm making films for over the past 100 years. Together we have been laughing, crying, and sitting at the end of our seats, and it's all because of you guys. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out and spending your day here with us at Universal. Now I have some tips that might make your trip to next trip Universal a little better. If you don't already have it, if you download the Universal Studios Hollywood app, you're going to know the wait times for all the rides in the park. You're going to get that park hours when we're open and when we close. You're also going to be able to get the digital cue for the Secret Life of Pets if you want to turn into a puppy. And if you're interested in any of the films you saw today on our lot, you're more than welcome to visit any one of our retail stores in the park and get them. This is Universal Studios Hollywood, the entertainment capital of LA. And that's a wrap. Thank you so much, you guys. You guys have been an awesome trip. I've had an amazing time tonight, and I hope you guys did as well. We have some Christmas lighting going on today. We got the castle at Harry Potter happening. I highly recommend that. That is such a fun show. Thank you so much, you guys. Have a great rest of your night.
Oh God. Alright, just be careful guys. Please watch your step and make sure to throw your glasses in the bin.